This lesson covers how to create a simple PID by placing elements such as equipment, pipelines, valves, and instruments. The PID file used for this lesson was created in a previous session. Before placing the first equipment, let's set the specification in the Standard Preferences dialog to MCS 150. The values for area, service, unit, and system have already been set and explained in the previous lesson. This exercise begins by placing a pump. The different pump types can be found in the equipment ribbon. Choose the horizontal centrifugal pump and put it in the PID. Enter the pump's tag information in the placement dialog. Type 0600 in the number field and click OK. Place the primary tag annotation right below the pump and the secondary tag around the perimeter of the PID. The next step is to place a tank to the right of the pump. Still in the Equipment ribbon, pick the Tanks and Vessels button to get the component gallery. Select the cone roof tank symbol and pick two points on the PID to define the tank's limits. Again, the tag dialog loads. Enter the tank's tag name by entering 0600 into the number field and click OK. Place the primary tag inside the vessel and then place the secondary tag around the perimeter of the PID. Use the grip or the edit handles to move the tank up a little. And then, do the same with the label and move that into the body of the tank symbol. After adding the two equipment, the lesson will continue by adding pipelines to the PID. Go to the Piping Ribbon group and select the major pipeline from the component gallery. After the dialog has loaded, set the pipeline's number to 0600. The associated items, such as pipe spec, area, service, and unit, have already been preset from the standard preferences. Before placing the pipeline, let's change its design size. Go to the Properties section of the dialog and scroll down to the Design Conditions category. Then pick the Design Size property, set that to 200, and click the OK button. After the dialog is closed, draw the pipeline from the pump's discharge to the tank. The session now continues by placing some components onto this pipeline. Still in the Piping ribbon, click the Valve section and select the check valve from the gallery. Change the snap to nearest if the pipeline is not drawn onto the grid. Select the pipeline on which to place the valve symbol. Then, when the pipe spec window appears, pick the first catalog item from the list and click the OK button. The last step again is to tag the component. The placement process is the same across all components in the PID by selecting the symbol from the gallery first, placing it in the PID and entering its tag information. Click the OK button to complete. Now let's place a gate valve on that same pipeline. Again, select from the spec and click the OK button. Then tag the valve by entering 601 to the number property and click OK. This session now continues by placing some instruments. For that, switch to the corresponding ribbon menu and select the Instruments group to get the Components gallery. Pick the discrete symbol from the gallery to put a pressure indicator on this pipeline. Place the discrete instrument and drag the line down to connect it to the pipeline. Tag the instrument by assigning a device type code PI and a number 0600. Click the OK button. The first pipe run is now completed. It connects to equipment, got some inline components, and has an instrument. The next step in this session is to add the discharge piping. For that, zoom in on the area on the right-hand side of the vessel. Go to the Piping ribbon and select Major from the Component gallery to place another process line. Tag the pipeline by entering a number, for example, 0601. Still, in the same dialog, go to the Properties section and browse to the Design Size. Select 200 from the pick list and click the OK button. Now route the pipeline off the vessel's base going to the right, then go down, and finally drag it over to the right somewhere near the edge of the page. The next step will cover adding a pipe run to the existing pipeline. For that, go back to the Piping ribbon group and, from the Component gallery, pick the Pipe Run tool. The way pipe run works is first to initiate the command, then pick on the pipeline from which the pipe run needs to extend. For this exercise, start from the vertical segment of the previously drawn pipeline and drag it to the right. Use the AccuDraw to align the pipe run to the end of the other pipeline. All necessary pipe run parameters have been inherited from the selected pipeline. No changes are needed as this new pipe run will be part of the same pipeline using the same size. Click the OK button to complete. This exercise continues by adding a reducer to the pipeline. Go to the Fittings Ribbon group and select the concentric reducer from the gallery. Select the pipeline to which the reducer will be inserted. When the split run dialog appears, press the OK button to confirm the proposed new run name for the highlighted parts. The next step is to change the size of the new pipe run. When the pipe run dialog appears, go to the Design Properties group and change the size to 80. Then click OK button. Notice that the reducer corrects itself as it orientates automatically in the right direction. Let's now change the size of the other pipe run to 80 as well. This session continues by placing a ball valve in each of the two runs. Go to the Valves Ribbon group and select the ball valve in the gallery. After selecting the pipe run, the spec dialog appears. This time select the flanged valve from the list and click the OK button. Set the valve's tag number to 602 and click OK. Now let's place the second valve. As with the previous one, pick the flanged option from the spec list. Set the tag's number to 603 and click the OK button to complete the placement process. The next step is to place a fitting. Go to the Fitting Ribbon group and pick the flexible hose from the gallery. Put the flexible hose on the end of one of the upper pipelines so that it will allow the offload. Note that placing a fitting does usually not require a tag to be assigned. Another instrument is the last component to be placed as part of this training. For that, first, zoom into the area to the right of the tank. Then select the discrete instrument from the component gallery and place it somewhere to the right of the tank. This time, do not draw a line from the instrument, just click the right button on the mouse, and the new component dialog will appear. Enter LG into the device type code field and 0600 into the number property. Click the OK button. Now place two instrument lines to complete the level gauge. Go to the Instrument Lines ribbon group and select Process from the gallery. For both lines, start drawing the line from the vessel to the instrument. Next, the session continues by looking into the annotation process. First, let's pick on the check valve. After right-clicking, select Annotate from the context menu. Then pick the name property. Either double-click on it or click the Place Annotation button. Place the annotation beneath the valve symbol. Note that the Annotate command remains active. To annotate the other valves, just move around the drawing and repeat the steps by selecting the component and again, double-click on the name property to place the annotation. Next, this exercise continues by adding some pipeline annotations. Switch to the Piping Ribbon section and click the Pipeline Annotations group. From the Component Gallery, select the standard pipeline type. Simply by picking on or dragging across the pipeline, it picks up the pipeline's tag information. In this case, the pipeline name. Place that on the PID and repeat for the other pipelines. Adding some flow arrows to the pipelines will complete this exercise. Go to the Piping Services ribbon group and select Flow Arrow from the gallery. To place the flow arrows, either snap to the middle of the line or use any other snap options, like nearest. Place a couple of flow arrows. Alternatively, rather than manually placing the flow arrows, it is also possible to switch them on and off from the pipe run's flow arrow properties. Now, other than page connectors, this PID is now completed.